After a month of campaigning, this federal election will be a fight to the finish.
I just think it's a mug's game to try to predict this one.
As we enter the final weekend of the campaign, many polls still show a tight race between the Liberals and Conservatives, with the NDP in a distant third. And experts say this race will come down to the wire. While the numbers point to a likely minority government, a majority may also be in the cards.
There's so many too close to call ridings. And if a lot of those go in one direction rather than the other, that could shift towards very close to majority territory. There's a lot of seats in play in the Toronto area, in Ontario. There's a lot of seats in British Columbia, and even Quebec is a wild card.
For party leaders in this tight race, these final days of campaigning will be crucial. And for the front runners, they'll be pushing a message of strategic voting,
where the Liberals will say, don't vote for the NDP because that'll secure a Conservative victory. And the Conservatives will say, don't vote for the PPC because that'll secure a Liberal victory.
For the other parties, it's about staving off the scare tactics and preserving any leads they may have in this campaign. Another major factor will be voter turnout. Despite record advance and mail-in ballots, there's a good chance the pandemic keeps people home and voter turnout low. So expect a big push to get supporters to the ballot box, with a bombardment of TV and radio ads, flyers, phone calls, text messages, emails, and even offers from parties to drive you to your polling station. Cormac McSweeney, City News, Ottawa.